Hi guys, in the last video I have shown you how to solve a consignment problem, and it was a simple problem and I hope you guys have understood it. Okay, now in this video I'm going to explain it to you how to calculate the value of stock. Okay, so what is valuation of stock? Valuation of stock is nothing but to calculate the value of goods that is unsold by the consignee. Okay, alright, now moving on to the question. Amit sent 100 cycles costing of rupees 50,000 to Rohit to be sold at a commission of 10% on sales. Okay, so here Amit has sent goods to Rohit. So Amit is consigner and Rohit is consignee. Okay, next, Amit paid freight and insurance of 1,800 on the goods. So Amit has incurred some expenses, that is freight and insurance of rupees 1,800 to send the goods. Okay, then the account sales sent by Rohit showed that he sold 80 cycles at 700 each and paid octroi of rupees 400 and carriage of rupees 300. So Rohit has also incurred some expenses to receive the goods. Okay, then it is said advertisement, storage and selling expenses incurred were rupees 200. So there are some expenses incurred by Rohit to sell the goods. Okay, these are also called as selling expenses or recurring expenses. Okay, next it is said calculate the value of consignment stock. So I will show you how to make the valuation of consignment stock. Okay, all right okay, next important thing is you need to understand the concept of recurring expenses and non-recurring expenses. Okay, what are these two and what is the difference between these two? The difference is that non-recurring expenses are occurred in or incurred in transit. Okay, they are incurred in transit, and recurring expenses are those expenses which are incurred before or after transit. Before or after transit. For example, non-recurring expenses are those such as freight, which is incurred in the transit, and insurance on goods that is in transit. Okay, insurance in transit and duty, octroi, all these expenses are incurred in transit. And recurring expenses examples are rent of showroom or warehouse, storage expenses, okay, and advertisement to increase sales, etc. So these expenses are incurred before or after the transit, and non-recurring expenses are incurred in the transit. Okay, this is the major difference between these two. And in the valuation of consignment stock, only these expenses are needed to be considered. Okay, important in valuation of stock, these expenses are not taken in the valuation of consignment stock. Okay, alright, if you need to understand more about these expenses, then you can watch the introduction of this topic and understand the concept in detail. Okay, alright. Okay, at first you need to calculate the closing stock. Okay, that is the stock that is unsold by the consignee. Okay, so first you need to take the number of goods consigned. Okay, number of goods consigned. In this case, here we'll take number of cycles consigned. Okay, equal to 100, the quantity, not the amount, the quantity. Okay, minus number of cycles or goods that are sold, number of cycles sold, which is equal to 80. It's given in the question, which gives us 20. Okay, this will be the closing stock, the stock which is remained with the consignee. Okay, next I will show you how to value this 20 cycles. Okay, easy, right? Okay. Okay, after the calculation of closing stock and finding out the amount of stock that is unsold by the consignee, you have to make the valuation of that closing stock. Okay, so to do that, there is a small formula, that is cost price. Okay, cost price of closing stock, cost price of closing stock plus proportionate non-recurring expenses. Okay, non-recurring expenses, the expenses which are incurred in transit. Okay, so how to add the proportionate non-recurring expenses? To do that, you have to take the amount of non-recurring expenses into closing stock. Okay, into closing stock divided by the total stock. Okay, which will give us the value of closing stock. Okay, easy, right? All right, now we will apply this formula to our problem. Okay, so first we'll find the cost price of one cycle, because the cost price of one cycle is not given in the question. Okay, so to do that, we'll take 50,000, that is the cost price of all the cycles, all the 100 cycles, divided by 100. Okay, divided by the quantity, total amount divided by quantity, which will give us the price, that is 500. Okay, now after finding the cost price of one cycle, we will apply the valuation of stock formula, that is cost price of 20 cycles, cost price of 20 cycles, which is equal to 20 into 500 equal to 10,000. Okay, plus proportionate non-recurring expenses, which is 2,500, that is freight and insurance and octroi and carriage. Okay, so the total expenses are 2,500, total non-recurring expenses, into the closing stock, that is 20. Okay, divided by the total stock sent by the consignor, that is 100. Okay, so 2,500 into 20 divided by 100 is equal to 500. Okay, so 10,000 plus 500 is equal to 10,500, which gives us the value of 20 cycles. Okay, we have found the value of the closing stock, and this will be credited in the consignment account as buy consignment stock. Okay, easy, right? All right.